In this session, let us learn about the West Indian literature. You see, in this particular session, let us try to understand the two different terms, West Indies and Caribbean. And let us try to understand the meaning of transplanted and transported culture of West Indies. And let us also try to understand the agony of language and the various voices of West Indies and various literary forms that were practiced in West Indies. So let us learn. After this session, you must be in a position to differentiate the West Indies and Caribbean, and you must learn the two cultures, transported and transplanted cultures, and you must also know what creolization is in West Indies, and you must learn the various literary forms of West Indies, West Indian writers. So first let us try to know the difference between Caribbean and West Indies. The term Caribbean emphasizes geographical and historical determinants. The term Caribbean refers to a geographical area, and it is based on the history. It indicates the geographical region. Caribbean, the term, refers to the geographical region or an area which covers Caribbean islands. Caribbean islands include all the territories associated with European powers like Britain, France, French, Portugal, and other countries. As you know, Caribbean islands are innumerable in number. When Europeans colonized, British took control of certain islands, French took control of certain islands, Spanish people took control of some other islands. So most of the European powers took control of so many other islands. All these islands, which were under the British rule, French rule, Spanish rule, and Portugal rule, put together are called Caribbean islands. It is a geographical area, and it is based on the historical determinants or factors that they were under the control of the European powers under colonization. On the other hand, West Indies is based on linguistic determinant of the use of English. But West Indies is a group of islands which come under Caribbean islands, but these islands are based on linguistic determinants or factors. West Indies islands use English language because they were under the control of the British. They were colonized by the British. These islands are called West Indies. West Indies islands are a few islands among the Caribbean islands. You see, West Indies consists of English speaking regions of the Caribbean islands. It is very clear. Some of the islands which were under the control of the British, they consist of English speaking regions. The people in those islands which were under the control of the British, quite naturally they speak English language. These Caribbean islands are called West Indies. These four islands, Guyana, Jamaica, Trinidad, and Barbados, these four islands are called West Indies. They are also Caribbean islands, but they were under the control of the British. The people in those islands speak English language. That is why these islands are called West Indies. That is the difference between the Caribbean islands and the West Indies island. Caribbean islands are geographical area, and they are based on the historical factors. On the other hand, West Indies is based on the linguistic factors where people speak English language. They are also Caribbean islands, but these four islands were ruled by the British colonizers. People there speak English language and generally follow the English culture. That is why these islands are called West Indies Islands. In this particular session, we are going to learn about the West Indies literature, not about the Caribbean literature. Caribbean literature is a vast area which covers so many other literatures from French and other regions. But in this particular session, we learn about the English literature of West Indies. History of West Indies. Let us try to know the history of West Indies. As you know, the Caribbean Sea surrounds the West Indies Islands. West Indies Islands fall in the Caribbean Sea. Caribs and Arawakas were the original dwellers of these islands. The tribal people called Caribs and Arawakas were the original inhabitants or dwellers of these West Indies Islands. The arrival of Columbus from Europe and some other Europeans who later came to West Indies annihilated their oral literature and the makers of oral literature. When Columbus came to West Indies, he was followed by some other Europeans. These Europeans exterminated or annihilated the culture, oral literature that was there in West Indies Islands. They erased the oral literature of the West Indies and the makers of West Indies literature. So, Caribs and Arawakas, these true tribal communities and their literature were erased by the European colonizers. The masters of slave trade and plantation labor destroyed their culture, language, and way of life and other things. The masters of slave trade from European countries who brought slaves to West Indies from the African countries, they brought the slaves for plantation labor in West Indies. These people destroyed the West Indies culture of Caribs and Arawakas. They destroyed the language of the West Indies people or these tribal people, and they disturbed their way of life and other things. So the slaves brought from Africa did not share the common language, common tradition and common culture. As you know, Africa has so many countries. Africans speak different languages. They have different dialects. And they follow their own culture based on the region. So we cannot find one particular culture, one particular language and one particular tradition in Africa. So there are thousands of languages, thousands of traditions and culture. The slaves who were brought to West Indies from Africa were from different cultures. They spoke different languages. They followed different traditions. That is why they were not able to follow one common language, one common tradition, or one common culture in West Indies. Quite naturally, these slaves who were brought from Africa to West Indies started imitating the British and the French in West Indies. They forgot their own culture, their own language and their own tradition. Quite naturally, they began to imitate the British and the French. This is the history of West Indies. Later, Asians were also transported as indentured labor in West Indies. In the beginning, Europeans brought the African slaves to work in their plantations in West Indies. when slavery was superseded in the year 1863. The Europeans were in need of different kind of labor. That is why they started importing laborers from India and other Asian countries. These indentured laborers were in no way different from the slaves. The only difference between these two was that laborers were purchased and sold and purchased. But indentured laborers were not sold. They were borrowed, hired. They were from India. So Asians and Africans had no land. On the one hand, we had African slaves in West Indies. On the other hand, we have indentured labor from the Indian Asian countries. So these people did not have land, their own land. Asians and Africans did not have their own land, did not have their own language. They left behind their culture, land, languages in their respective countries. So, all these slaves and laborers started imitating the European colonizers. So, the recorded history of West Indies is predominantly the history of imperialism. We do not find the original history of West Indies. We do not have much history of the tribal communities. So, the history of West Indies is the history of imperialism. That is why a very well-known writer, V.S. Naipaul, who hails from Indian origin, thought it was the destitute society. West Indies society is a destitute society without history or achievement. It has no history of its own and it has no achievement of its own. It is the history of the colonizers and the imperial governments. Later, the African-rooted writers tried to infuse their own past into their European acquisition. After a few years, the African-rooted writers, the writers who were from Africa, they tried to infuse their own past, African past, into the West Indies literature. West Indies history, they started infusing their past into their European acquisition. So we have transplanted and transported culture in West Indies. The West Indies culture is not the culture of West Indies. It is the transplanted culture. Transplant means taking from one country and planting it in another country. You see, the culture of Africa was transplanted and transplanted in West Indies. Similarly, the Indian culture through indentured labor was transplanted in West Indies. That is why this culture is called transported culture. Transported from African countries and from the Asian countries, and it was transplanted in West Indies. So it is quite common, quite clear that the people of West Indies are a mixed race of the Europeans, Africans and Asian origin. So West Indies is an hybrid country where we find the people from mixed races. Some are European, some are Africans, some more are from the Asian countries. Their culture was largely decided by the white rulers, but the West Indies culture is purely based on the white rulers because they were very dominant in West Indies. They ruled the islands. They imparted their education and they gave their own religion to these people. That is why their culture was very dominant. They gave them their colony, gave them colonies, their language and education to the people, laborers, slaves. They feel a sense of exile and uprooted from their roots and transplanted. So most of the people in West Indies are exiled people. They came to West Indies from Africa, some from Asian countries and some from the European countries, even though they are the colonizers. So these people who are there in West Indies thought that they are the uprooted from their own roots. They were removed from their roots, their native country, and transplanted in another country, that is West Indies. So these people who were transported and transplanted had an agony of their language because they were not able to speak their own language. They did not have an opportunity to speak their own languages because they were from different linguistic backgrounds, religious backgrounds, cultural backgrounds. So the slaves who were brought from Africa and indentured laborers who are brought from Asian countries were unable to communicate in their native languages or tongues. They faced the difficulty of common language. They did not share the common language. It was very difficult for them to communicate each other. So these people developed the Caribbean Creoles. They developed the Caribbean Creoles. What does the term Creole mean? You see, Creole is the language of the slaves, laborers, peasants, and the poor. The language these common people, slaves, laborers, peasants, and poor spoke is called Creole. Creole is the language, hybrid language. It is a mixture of some European languages and native dialects. So these people started speaking the Creole, and the standard English was the language of education, it was the language of administration, a language of business, and it was the language of the whites and the mulattoes. You know, mulattoes are the people, hybrid people, who have white father and the black mother. Children born to white father and black mother. They are called mulattoes. They are the hybrid people who descended from Europeans and also from the Africans. So these people spoke English language. Standard English was spoken by these people. They used it in administration, in education, business. But the common people used the Caribbean Creoles, which is an hybrid language. Even some writers, they creolized the literature of the islands. Some of the writers in West Indies started writing not in English, not completely in English, but in creolized languages. Creolized is a language, is the mixture of both English and other languages, which were spoken by the common people in West Indies. So we find various voices in West Indies. Each region and each ethnic group has its own voice, since they are from different parts of the world. They are from different ethnic groups. The people add their own voices. They try to develop a unified culture and identity. These people who were transported and transplanted try to develop a unified culture and identity in West Indies. Even British Broadcasting Corporation sponsored a program called Caribbean Voices between 1945 and 1958 for almost 13 years. It greatly enhanced cultural consciousness. Caribbean Voices. People from Caribbean islands, as we know already, are from different cultures and from different countries. These people had their own voices. So there are so many voices in West Indies. These voices were aired by British Broadcasting Corporation. Earlier writers in West Indies imitated European writers, but later writers voiced their own displacement, their identity crisis and lost identity, and some other aspects of their own life. Earlier writers quite naturally imitated the European writers because they learnt or studied the European writers. Later, they developed a sense of their own identity. Then they started voicing the difficulties of their own displacements from different countries. They were displaced, as you know, transplanted from different countries. They started talking or voicing their own problems of displacement, and they had an identity crisis, and they had lost their own original identity. So they started talking about all these issues in their literary works. So let us try to know some of the West Indies writers, particularly the poets first. Claude Mackay is one important West Indies poet. He wrote Home to Yerlam in the year 1928. He is a very important poet from West Indies. H.G. D. Lissay is another poet who lived between 1887 and 1944. Derek Walcott is one of the very important West Indies writer who lived between 1930 and 2017. He was from the island Saint Lucia. Another important poet was Edward Braithwaite. He was born in the year 1930. He was from the island Barbados in West Indies. Similarly, Martin Carter is another poet who hails from Guyana Island. He lived between 1927 to 1997. Alfred Mendes and C.L.R. James are two story writers. They experimented with regional speech and dialect. These two story writers experimented with regional speech. Regional speech is the Creole. They started writing in Creole language and the regional dialects. So West Indies writers, they made so many experiments in their writings. So we have a unique West Indies literature these days. Even though they imitated European writers in the beginning, they developed their own literature and followed a unique style. Let us come to Caribbean fiction or West Indies fiction. Fiction occupied quite a place in Caribbean fiction. Some of the fiction writers are very, very important and very innovative. One such writer is Edward Middleholzer, who lived between 1910 and 1965. He wrote a novel called A Morning at the Office in the year 1950. This novel deals with the contradiction of being white in mind and black in body. You see, it is very, very interesting. In this particular novel, it deals with the issue of being, deals with contradiction, confusion, a dilemma. The dilemma is of being white in mind and black in body. See, a particular person is white mentally. Yes, an white mind, but black in body. It means to say that he has an European language, European culture, European religion to practice. And on the other hand, his physical body is from the blacks or Negroes from the Africa. So he has an identity crisis and he has two different races in him. Samuel Selwyn is another novelist who lived between 1923 and 94. He wrote a novel called The Brighter Sun in the year 1952. The novel portrays the Indians in Trinidad Island. It is particularly about Indians in Trinidad. Another novelist is V.S. Reid, who lived between 1913 and 1987. He deals with multicultural and multi-racial issues in his novels. You see, most of the writers deal with the identity, multiculturalism, multi-racial issues and multi-linguistic issues in their literary works. So Caribbean fiction is particularly on multicultural and multi-racial issues. Even Jean Rice is another important novelist who lived between 1895 and 1979. Her important novel Wide Sargasso Sea was published in the year 1966, and it depicts suffering and exploitation of women in West Indies. It is about the women in West Indies. Another very important novelist from West Indies is V.S. Naipaul. He is a descendant from India. He wrote a novel called House of Mr. Biswas, House of Mr. Biswas, which deals with the suffering of Indian community in West Indies. He particularly talks about the Indian community in West Indies, and he pictures the difficulties and sufferings of Indian community in West Indies in that particular novel. Wilson Harris is another great novelist from West Indies. He wrote a novel called Guiana Quarter in the year 1960. He constructs and reconstructs history of the Caribs and Arawakas, who are the original inhabitants of West Indies. He tries to construct and reconstruct the history of West Indies, because West Indies doesn't have its own history. History begins with the history of imperialism. So, even though West Indies is a small country with just four islands, it has its own unique literature. So, let us recap whatever we learnt in this particular session. It is very clear that West Indies lacks history of its own. Its history begins with the history of imperialism. And transplanted people or writers wrote in Caribbean Creoles about ethnic, linguistic and national identities. Transported and transplanted people in West Indies started writing in Caribbean Creoles. They wrote about their own ethnic, their own linguistic and their own national identities in their literary works. And most of the West Indies writing is post-colonial. Post-colonial, they did not write when they were under the British rule. We didn't have any history of West Indies in the pre-colonial period. We have the literature of West Indies written only after post-colonialism. So West Indies writing is post-colonial. And most of the writers were educated abroad. That is another important thing. Most of the West Indies writers were educated either in Europe or in America. The island didn't have the educational institutions, since they are the small islands. So quite naturally, the writers got educated in European countries and in America. Some remained in foreign countries. Those who went to Europe for higher studies remained in Europe. Those who went to America for higher studies, they remained in America. Only a few visited their homelands. They frequently visit their homelands, but they have made their own European countries and cities in America. This is all about the West Indies literature. Just a glance, we made a glance at the West Indies literature. there are so many other writers and they created so many literary forms and they wrote in different styles using creoles and other things, discussed so many other issues. But we, for the time being, we had just a glance of West Indies literature and its various forms, and we familiarized ourselves with some important writers. Let us assess our understanding of West Indies literature. The two original dwellers of West Indies are Eskimos and Angles, Caribs and Arawakas, Africans and Europeans, Indians and Chinese. The original dwellers of West Indies are Caribs and Arawakas. Mulatto means a child having white mother and black father, African father and West Indies mother, Asian father and African mother, black mother and white father. Mulatto means a child having a black mother and a white father. They are called mulatto. They speak English language because they are of Indian and of Africans. The author of the novel House of Mr. Biswas is Jean Rhys, Samuel Selwyn, V.S. Naipaul, Wilson Harris. Yes. The author of the novel House of Mr. Biswas is V.S. Naipaul, of Indian origin. The indentured labor force was imported to West Indies from Africa, Europe, India, and China, America. The indentured labor force was imported to West Indies from India and China to Asian countries. A BBC program Caribbean Voices, which was aired between 1945 and 58, was run to enhance dash consciousness among the West Indians, ethnic, national, international, and cultural. Yes, to enhance the cultural consciousness among the West Indies. These are the books that I refer to prepare this presentation. Thank you for listening.